So we're back again for another tutorial. Adobe After Effects here is the program, and no, it is not free to the last person that made a comment on the last tutorial. This program will run you about $1,000, by the way, but in the end, if you're serious about video production and you work in this field, it is well worth paying for. Now, hey, maybe you don't have the cash for it. Are you working with a company? Are you working with someone that knows this piece of software? Maybe they'll pay for it. Maybe they own it already and they'll let you work on their system. So check with your boss or whatnot and see if they own the software that you can use over the weekend or whatnot for their business. If you're working for a company, normally that's the case and you don't have to buy it yourself. So let's get on with our tutorial here. We're going to be talking about software color correction type things here today. This is tutorial number 15, I believe, and we've got a lot to go over in a short amount of time here. I'm trying to keep this one under 10 minutes, maybe even 7 minutes if we can. But anyway, what we have here in our composition is a main camera, which is my high-definition Canon Vixia HFS100, which this is non-color corrected, by the way. It's just a single halogen light. And as you can see, the color correction, the white balance and all that is really, really good. So we'll keep that as is, and we'll move down to this picture-in-picture down here, which is my older camera, a Sony Handycam. I forget the model number of it, but it's about 5, maybe 6 years old at this point, and it runs off mini DV tape. And being that even in the highly lit environment, you'll notice a lot of grain even in the carpet here, and overall the image has a lot of grain in it, looking like the scene is too dark. The image sensors on it, the CCD sensors, or the CMOS in some cases, are not as large on smaller, older cameras, so you get a lot of grain in the image even under high lighting conditions, which was a drawback of this particular camera. But another drawback you see is that it looks really blue. Look at the skin tone. You got more of a yellow, bright color over here compared to the blue darkness over here. So what we're going to do is try to correct this main kick drum camera down here, this picture-in-picture. So if we go up to effects, we have a color correction panel, which has a multiple different choice of what we can do. We can do everything from auto color to auto contrast, auto levels, black and white, brightness and contrast, broadcast colors. So when you send things out to broadcast, they have to be under a specific set of numbers when it comes to the gain of the video itself. And when you start looking at histograms and everything like that, that is something you really have to keep an eye on. And normally you have hard limiters like the broadcast colors here that'll preset those and won't let those go over a certain level. But either way, we're going to keep it simple here. We're going to be looking at the number one thing that I like to work with here is the color correction called curves. Now, if you add this to our layer, our kick drum layer in our picture-in-picture here, you can notice that we have something here that adds. We have the selection of channel, which allows us to adjust the overall brightness, which is red, green, blue, and together, red, green, and blue all together. We have the red, green, blue individual, as well as an alpha channel. So maybe we'll talk later about alpha channels. That's a way to get a invisible type section in your video, so you can sort of add it to wherever you want and key it out easily. But either way, we're going to adjust the overall video here. Maybe we think there's a little bit too much blue in this channel, so we're going to select our blue channel. And before we go and adjust this, I want to just give you an overview. Towards the left is the dark side. Towards the right is our highlights. So we have shadows versus highlights. We can click anywhere on this particular line graph and add these anchor points that we can sort of drag around. You'll notice if I drag it up, it adds more blue. If I drag it down, it takes away the blue. If I drag this down towards the bottom, in fact, I'll even add another key point here, an anchor point by left-clicking single, and just lower the shadows. You'll notice that the darker areas sort of get greener because we're taking out the blues. Likewise, we could do the opposite and add blues to those dark shadows. But it's just something to look for when doing color correction and such. So we'll actually take out some of the blue in this, and it looks sort of even. The next thing we have to do, of course, is brighten it up. The overall brightness is a little bit low, so we're going to take our RGB color channel here and just boost it up right in the middle until we have something that's not blown out, but at the same time sort of looks even with the rest of the scene. You're not going to get it exact. Be aware of that. If you're working with multiple different cameras like I am, you're not going to get the color balance exact, but you can get it fairly close. Now, I don't know of any way to select an eyedropper tool and say, yo, this is supposed to be white, set it to that automatically. But maybe there is, I just haven't looked into it in Adobe After Effects CS 3, 4, or 5. So just be aware of that. And with that said, that's going to be the curves adjustment of this tutorial. Also be aware of the other ones here. We got different effects such as, go down here, we have stuff like Colorama, Color Stabilizer. Levels is another adjustment that you do, and this is really common. It gives you a histogram. We'll shut off this effect and shrink it down. This pretty much allows you to adjust the black and white levels, so you can brighten or darken everything. It's not really going to adjust color overall. If we expand this out some more, so we can sort of clip the white and black channels. Maybe on top of that, add the color balance for the curves and sort of do a compound effect on that. But just be aware of the different color effects. Maybe you have to do compound effects or insert multiple images into a scene, and one of the scenes isn't color balanced properly to fit into your night scene. Maybe it's taken midday or late day, and you want a color balance to look like it was nighttime to blend the two together for a composition effect. But as I said, you can't create miracles on this. If you're working with different cameras, they pick up the color differently, and you're not going to create the same effect overall. So just be aware of that. I'm Dave from Sonicorp Studios. This has been a 7-minute tutorial. Yeah, I kept it short for you on Adobe After Effects CS5. Thank you for commenting, rating, subscribing. We're almost up to 700 subscribers now on my YouTube channel. Check out my website, sonicorpstudios.squarespace.com. And until next time, I'll see you then.